question because it is part of Ahlul Bid'ah, the people of innovation, to judge other people's aqidah. So the takfir and al-hijrah, which appeared in Egypt like 35 or 40 years ago, maybe more, they used to label anyone who's not part of their cult to be kafir. And they would immediately label people, classify them, have no problem in killing them, taking their wealth, just because they don't believe, belong to their jama'ah. Then appeared a lesser in extremism, a group lesser in extremism, and they used to be called at-tawakkuf wa-tabayyun, meaning that they don't label others to be kafir, but they don't label them to be Muslim as well, until they determine through questionnaires, through investigation, whether they're Muslims like them or not. And this is also part of the Khawarij, because the default is whoever prays our prayer and faces our Qibla and eats from our slaughtering sacrifice or animals, then he is from among us. To go and refuse to pray in a particular masjid, why? I don't know if the Imam is an Ash'ari or a Mu'tazili or a Sufi or a Khawarij or this or that. Okay, what do you want to do? So, well, I have a crash test. I have a quiz, a multiple choice quiz. He has to answer these questions before I can pray behind him. This is ridiculous. This is what Ahlul al-Bid'ah do. To me, any person who claims to be a Muslim, until proven otherwise, I can pray behind him. Yes, Sheikh, but they're involved in some bid'ah like mulid, like congregational dua after prayer. All of these are innovations, true, but they do not nullify their Islam. I refrain from praying behind someone who nullifies his Islam through a conviction or a belief. But such little innovations are major sins, and they have to refrain. I can advise them. It does not impact the validity of my prayer, and Allah knows best.